Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India.
Good evening, welcome to South Asia Newsline. I am Uzma Jafri. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Friday, the 19th of February. Three terrorists, three policemen killed in separate encounters in India's Jammu and Kashmir. China admits four soldiers killed in Galwan Valley clash with India. And NATO chief dismisses early troop pullout from Afghanistan. And now for all the details. Three terrorists were neutralized and three police personnel lost their lives in separate encounters and a terror attack in India's Jammu and Kashmir on Friday. A massive anti-terror operation was launched by security forces in the Union Territory till the last reports came in.
Security forces gunned down three terrorists and one security personnel was killed in separate encounters in Shopian and Budgam districts of India's northern Jammu and Kashmir on Friday. The encounter in Shopian broke out after a search operation was launched by security forces late on Thursday. Three terrorists belonging to Al-Badr terror group were gunned down early on Friday after being encircled, a senior police official said. Meanwhile, in a separate encounter, one police personnel lost his life during anti-terror operations in Budgam district.
और मॉर्निंग में 5:30 में जब घरवाले को निकाल लिए हम लोग फिर से इनकाउंटर शुरू हो गया दौरान इनकाउंटर तीन टेररिस्ट मारे गए जो अलबदर से ताल्लुक रखते हैं तीनों लोकल मिलिटेंट हैं दो AK-47 एक पिस्टल मिला है
मीनवाइल इन अनदर इंसिडेंट ऑन फ्राइडे टेररिस्ट फायर्ड अपॉन पुलिसमैन फ्रॉम अ क्लोज रेंज इन श्रीनगर इन जम्मू एंड कश्मीर किलिंग टू पर्सनल द एरिया वॉज इमीडिएटली कॉर्डन ऑफ एंड अ सर्च ऑपरेशन वॉज अंडर वे to nab the attackers till the last reports came in.
A New Delhi court on Friday sent 22-year-old Indian climate activist Disha Ravi to three-day judicial custody in farmers' protest toolkit case. Disha Ravi was arrested past weekend for allegedly creating and sharing a toolkit, an online document that police said was used to foment violence during a mass protest by farmers in Delhi last month.
A New Delhi court on Friday sent 22-year-old Indian climate activist Disha Ravi, who was arrested past weekend on charges of sedition in the farmers' protest toolkit case, to three-day judicial custody. Appearing on behalf of the Delhi police, a public prosecutor told Delhi's Patiala House Court that during interrogation, Disha Ravi shifted the blame on co-accused Shantanu and Nikita Jacob for allegedly creating and sharing the toolkit, an online document that police said stoked violence in the national capital on January 26 during a farmers' tractor rally. The court granted the three-day custody after the prosecutor reasoned Disha needs to be confronted with Shantanu when he joins the probe on February 22. Swedish climate activist Greta Thunberg had also tweeted a link to the toolkit in early February and later deleted that post, drawing international attention to the months-long farmers' protest against the Indian government's move to deregulate agriculture produce markets and open them to private players. Politicians, students and activists have condemned and held several protests against the arrest of Ravi, a founding member of the local arm of Thunberg's Fridays for Future Climate Change movement.
Moving on. After months of denial over casualties in border confrontation with India, China said for the first time on Friday that four Chinese soldiers died during a bloody Himalayan border clash with Indian troops in June 2020. Adding that the men were given posthumous awards. Chinese Foreign Ministry in a press briefing on Friday said a commander who survived with injuries also received an award. China had earlier refused to disclose details of casualties in the clash in Galwan Valley in which 20 Indian soldiers died. This admission also coincides with the disengagement of troops by both sides at the north and south banks of the Pangong Lake that had become a flashpoint in their prolonged border row. Meanwhile, reports have surfaced that disengagement process has been completed in Pangong So, and both sides will discuss disengagement from other friction points. The 10th round of talks between military commanders of India and China reportedly will be held on Saturday. In news from Pakistan, Pakistan People's Party Chairman Bilawal Bhutto Zardari has claimed that lawmakers of the ruling PTI will vote for his party in the upcoming Senate elections, saying they know their own government is going to collapse soon. This comes as Pakistan is scheduled to hold the Senate election on 3rd of March.
Chairman of PPP Pakistan People's Party Bilawal Bhutto Zardari has claimed that lawmakers of the ruling PTI will vote for his party in the upcoming Senate elections, saying they know their own government is going to collapse soon. The remarks by Bilawal were made while addressing his party workers in Pakistan's Karachi city on Thursday to celebrate Tuesday's by-polls victory in Sangar and Mali districts of Sindh held earlier this week.
वो इनके कहने पे क्यों वोट देंगे उनको नजर आ रहा है कि इलेक्शन कराची में हो या सांगर में हो पाकिस्तान पीपल्स पार्टी पीटीआई को इबरतनाक शिकस्त दे रही है तो वो खुशी खुशी पाकिस्तान पीपल्स पार्टी के साथ आ रहे हैं.
This comes as Prime Minister Imran Khan's government has recently promulgated ordinance to introduce open ballot in the Senate polls next month in a bid to block horse trading in the upper house of parliament.
More on news from Pakistan. Renowned Pakistani mountaineer Muhammad Ali Sadpara and two other climbers who went missing earlier this month while attempting to scale K2, the world's second highest mountain, have been declared dead by officials after hectic efforts spanning over 2 weeks to locate them failed to produce any positive result.
Pakistani officials said three climbers missing on the K2 mountain had died, calling off an extraordinary rescue mission that had involved the military and international mountaineers since the group lost contact on February 5. Muhammad Ali Sadpara of Pakistan, John Snorri of Iceland and Juan Pablo Mohr of Chile were last seen just 300 meters short of the summit of K2, the world's second highest mountain. It is believed the group reached the summit but encountered a problem on the way down. The search for the bodies of the climbers will continue, officials said. The three were last seen by Sadpara's son Sajid, who had to turn around because of an oxygen supply malfunction.
जो क्लाइंबर्स है और उनके चाहने वालों से को यकीन दिलाता हूँ कि इंशाल्लाह वालिद का जो पाथ था और एडमिशन था उसको जारी रखूँगा और उसी के नक्शे कदम पर चलूँगा.
All three were strong mountaineers, willing, able and with the courage to make history by standing on the top of K2 in winter conditions. Based on the timing of the last known contact by John Snorri's telephone, we are confident that all three men made it to the top of K2 and such something happened on the descent.
Extremely low temperatures and gusting winds make it nearly impossible to survive on K2 for more than a few days. Tributes to Ali Sadpara poured in from Pakistanis online.
In news from Afghanistan, NATO defense ministers have made no decision on whether or when to pull out of Afghanistan at a meeting on Thursday. Secretary General Jens Stoltenberg said, adding that the allies faced a dilemma as violence increases again.
NATO Secretary General Jens Stoltenberg said Thursday at the end of NATO defense ministers' meetings in Brussels that the military alliance will only leave Afghanistan when security conditions on the ground allow it. At this stage, the alliance has not made a final decision about a troop presence in Afghanistan, he added. After 2 decades of Western military intervention and hundreds of billions of dollars in investment, NATO countries are reluctant to heed a May 1 deadline and risk undermining progress towards democracy as a peace process stalls.
Defense ministers had a thorough discussion on the situation in Afghanistan. We are faced with many dilemmas, and there are no easy options. At this stage, we have made no final decision on the future of our presence. But as the 1st of May deadline is approaching, NATO allies will continue to closely consult and coordinate in the coming weeks.
Attacks in Afghanistan, including a bomb that killed the deputy governor of the capital Kabul in December, have prompted members of the US Congress and international rights groups to call for a delay to the pullout, agreed when Donald Trump was US president. Stoltenberg said US Defense Secretary Lloyd Austin promised to consult with allies and partners on the way forward. Meanwhile, the progress in talks between the delegation representing the Islamic Republic of Afghanistan and the Taliban, launched on September 12 last year, has been slow and overshadowed by high-level violence.
Moving on to news from Nepal. The student wing of the Dahil Nepal faction of the Nepal Communist Party held a massive demonstration in capital Kathmandu on Thursday against the frequent price hike of petroleum products. They raised anti-government slogans and demanded immediate withdrawal of the decision.
The student wing of the Dahil Nepal faction of the Nepal Communist Party on Thursday held a protest in capital Kathmandu against the frequent price hike of petroleum products. The protesters, affiliated to the All Nepal National Free Students' Union, raised anti-government slogans outside the Office of Nepal Oil Corporation, or NOC, and demanded immediate withdrawal of the decision of price hike. With the revised price citing automated pricing system, petrol now costs Rs. 114 per litre. Kerosene and diesel cost Rs. 97 per litre each, and aviation fuel cost Rs. 67 per litre. The NOC had earlier also revised prices along with the cooking gas on February 10.
Chunavko natak manchan garera ra chunav kharcha uthaune jo garne galat uddeshyaka sath एक हप्तामा जनताको प्रत्यक्ष दैनिकीसँग प्रभाव गर्ने कुरा पेट्रोलियम पदार्थमा हप्तामा दुई पटक मूल्य वृद्धि गरेको छ.
The sudden rise in fuel prices with political situation looming under uncertainty. The protesters raised questions over the move by the state-owned Nepal Oil Corporation, which has often been criticized for being reluctant to reduce prices, even as the fuel prices drop in the international market.
Markets in India's Jammu and Kashmir are receiving a good number of customers as locals, in order to maintain their protein levels during winters, are stocking up on pulses. People buy and consume huge quantity of pulses in Kashmir Valley during winters to protect themselves from severe cold.
The consumption of pulses in India's Jammu and Kashmir is rising as locals are consuming pulses in huge quantities to maintain protein levels during winter. As people in the valley change their food habits during winter to face the severe cold, markets are receiving a good number of customers. Different variety of pulses are grown in Kashmir, which is famous across India and world. Tourists who travel to the valley to witness its scenic beauty often take away the variety of pulses because of their nutritional values.
Is saal zyada hi raha kyunki is saal temperature bilkul kam raha minus raha is waqt february hai february mein bhi minus raha iski wajah se yahan pulses bahut chal raha hai.
They are the high content of proteins. Proteins are those things which یم بناوان چھ سن امیون سسٹم اردو جو ہمارا امیون سسٹم اچھا کرتے ہیں خاص کر ونٹرز میں سردیوں میں یہ بہت ضروری ہے.
ویرائٹی اف پلسز فرام آسٹریلیا ٹرکی اینڈ کینیا ار آلسو اویلیبل ان دی مارکیٹس اف کشمیر. ڈیمانڈ فار چک پیز کڈنی بینز لینٹنز مونگ بینز ار امنگ دی ہائیسٹ ڈیمانڈ ایوری ایئر ڈیورنگ دی ونٹر سیزن.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/sasianewsline and follow us on Twitter at @sasianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time next week. Have a great weekend. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button. Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.